Whoa! Hey, welcome everybody to this week's Streamisho. I hope you can hear us. We're using some new software, so this might get a little hairy along the way. Hairy just like my fellow host's hair.
You went...
I went...
Hairy like my hair.
Really? Hairy like your... Yeah, hairy like your hair. Okay, so yeah, let's start over. Let's rewind a bit. Welcome to this week's Streamisho, you guys. I'm Tim. With me today is Robin.
And my hair.
It's not Jasper and his hair. And behind the scenes and...
The going, wheels of misfortune.
Yeah, who's having the time of his life right now is Koen. So if you see somebody typing in the chat eventually when he gets things smooth.
Koen is super busy, but he should also not forget to turn on the raffle timer.
Yeah, that is good. That's a good point. Hey, yeah, they seem to be hearing us, so that's cool. And there's somebody else with us as well today.
The mighty Galactron.
It's Galactron. Galactron. Whatever, man.
He looks over us, making sure everything is safe.
Yeah, I think so. He looks kind of menacing, though.
Yeah.
He's the new visualization of... the new matchmaking system that's coming in, well, surprise,
soon.
Rise of Galactron.
Yeah.
That's the guy. So that's cool.
He's pretty big.
Talking about that, there's some news on the beta that should be launching today.
There is some good news, and unfortunately there's also some bad news. The good news is that we have fixed a lot of issues that came up during the first round of open beta, especially concerning issues on Linux and Mac. Thanks to everyone who helped out with the tests. Your logs and your feedback's been greatly appreciated and has helped us sort through all those issues. Unfortunately, one last-minute issue popped up today, which means the beta is not available at this time and probably won't be available until later today. That's a bit unfortunate. We really wanted to share today and show you what changed during the show. But I'll have to wait.
I'll have to wait till next time.
Yeah. but everyone who's excited about the Galactron, who you can't really see behind us anymore, he's going to be the background in the beta.
Yeah.
Right?
He's going to be the background, period. For a little while, at least.
Yeah.
Not sure how long, but he's going to be... He's a new background, so no more overdrive backgrounds. We've now got Galactron...
Watching over,
whatever, man. Potato, potato. I've heard it both ways. It's gonna be like that for a little while, watching over your chat and your matchmaking. So that's pretty cool. And of course, in the beta as well is the assist system.
That's
so
right.
That's be sure to check that out once the beta goes live later today.
And we talked about that last week. So yeah. If you help someone who's getting a kill, you are getting an assist. It doesn't really give you any more solar, but it does give you credit for your contribution to your team.
Yeah, so yeah, you have a bit of a better insight into how much involvement you had in all the fights during the entire match, which is pretty cool.
Yeah.
So that will be in the beta as well, alongside all the changes, the slight changes, the bug fixes, and all the stuff.
And we also have a lot of balance tweaks in this one.
Oh, balance tweaks are in this one.
If you've been watching the dev streams that we do regularly, you might have heard Jasper talk about some of the things he's going to change. A couple of things that are changing in, or at least changed in the beta, Jasper has removed double slow upgrades on Lone Star's Hyperbolt and Coco's Blaze or Art Attack. At least there's no more double slow upgrades for one single row of upgrades. So these have been changed. He's also nerfed Ix, and has buffed Raylan. So she can be a little bit more offensive. She's very, very good at defense right now, and he's shifting out around it. And something that we're experimenting with is Vinny and Spike now ignore all platforms that you can drop through.
So all those wide platforms that you could drop down, the glass platforms.
Exactly.
So that's interesting. So
if you're chasing someone, you no longer have to hit down every time you need to drop through a platform, because any other character can just hold it and then they drop. It does change a lot. It feels really different because now you also drop down a platform when you walk over it. But you shouldn't really be walking when you're
peeing. Yeah, you shouldn't really be walking. So be sure to check that out as well. I mean, there's you can still test all the matchmaking stuff. You can test the assist. You can test all the balance changes. Be sure to do that. Give us your feedback. I think the survey is still in there.
Yeah,
so
it should be.
Fill out the survey with all your feedback and do that, man.
Yeah.
Do it. Check it. Test it. Give us your feedback stuff.
Yeah, and then after this, we'll process your feedback again and probably put that into another beta. And if everything goes well, we might be looking at live betas next.
Yeah.
That's not sure. It really depends on how this beta turns out. But we are moving forward. Things are working a lot better than they did before. People who had connection issues previously have a very, very good chance that things will work for them this time. And we're just going to keep improving it until it's good and it's ready to go live.
Yeah.
All right.
So, yeah, that's so much for the beta. It's coming later today. If all goes well, it should be. Fingers crossed. And then
go
check it out. What's next? What's next on the agenda? Blah, blah, blah.
News. So there's some news. It's been saying news for a while, sorry.
It's been saying news. Doesn't matter.
So, something that's that we've been talking about for, I think, about 2 years? Maybe even longer.
It's been 2 years already?
Might have been more.
Might have been more.
Spectator mode.
Spectator mode.
Spectator mode. Work has finally started.
I'm not confirming to
Work has started on spectator mode. It's an actual production right now.
There's a dedicated team for it.
Yeah, we've been doing some preparations for it in the past couple of months. But now we're actually really getting into it, really making progress on it. We hopefully have some news on that quite soon. Going to be weeks at least, but we're making progress on it.
The thing we can give you an update on now is that it is in active production. There's art and the coders are working on it, getting stuff rolling. So that's pretty exciting, and we hope to be able to share some news about that in the near future.
Yeah.
So that's pretty cool.
And we'll show it off when we can.
Yeah, definitely. So next up, last weekend was the finals of the Awesome Brawl tournament.
Yeah.
Which was pretty exciting.
Really exciting. It's been the first big tournament we've had in a while, and it turned out really well. Over 40 teams participated.
That's quite a lot of teams.
That's quite a lot of teams. And in the end, Harry Butchers and the boys took victory from Mature Gaming. Yeah, a Mature Dad, sorry.
Mature Dads. That's, indirectly, that's also Mature Gaming, right?
Yeah, sorry. Mature Dads, they lost the finals to Harry Butchers. So congratulations to Harry Butchers, of course, and Paolo Shiz.
And the boys.
Don't forget the boys. Yeah, the boys are Paolo Shiz and Nanduello.
Nanduello.
congratulations to them, and thank you to everyone who participated in the tournament or helped out in making it happen. Tempus, he pretty much ran the show the entire tournament. But also thanks to the casters, Esther, Devmon. Sorry, I have a list. It's quite
a few. He's got a list of everybody we need to thank for the Awesome Brawl tournament. So hit it.
Mr. Pillow, Uberenzi, Slow Wolf, everyone's favorite, of course, Leader Burra, and Pasha, FW, and Maslink for all the other stuff. Damn, our TV shut down. and those before all the other stuff they did to actually make it happen, because not everyone who helped out with the tournament did streams or stuff like that. There's also been a couple of people working behind the scenes to make sure all the matches went well, all the scrims turned out well. So thanks everyone who helped out to make this happen, and we hope to see a lot more from you guys.
Yeah, thank you guys. It's been a really cool tournament. So
yeah.
Hope to see more. And there's already new tournaments coming up, so for everybody who wants to participate in more tournaments, check out the forums. There's one starting this weekend already, if I believe correctly.
There is one by Mr. Manager?
Mr. Manager.
If I remember correctly.
Yeah, Mr. Manager, that was the guy.
And we've heard some rumors from community members that they're organizing more for the coming months.
So yeah, keep an eye out. We will always be sharing your information about tournaments coming up and stuff like that on our social media, and we will try to mention them here as well, so you will always be updated if you follow us on the internet.
All right.
So as you might have noticed last week on those social media, is that Awesomenauts turned 4 years old.
Congratulations.
Congratulations.
Happy birthday.
Happy birthday.
Happy Awesome Day.
Although an asterisk has to be made, that's for the
PC version.
PC version of Awesomenauts. So the Steam version is turned 4 years old, which is pretty exciting.
We're looking into the past. It's kind of confusing. Sorry.
Yeah, it's a bit confusing at times. We'll probably be too late for the raffle side as well.
Oh, right.
So yeah, Awesomenauts turned 4 years old. So much has happened in those 4 years.
Yeah.
And
I have another list.
He's got another. Oh, we have another list. We'll get to that list in a second. First of all, we just like to thank everybody who's been with us since the beginning.
Or joined later.
Who joined later, who's still with us right now. It's been a crazy ride. And it's been really exciting.
The game is so much bigger than it was 4 years ago.
It's crazy. If you look back at what it was then and what it is now, it's crazy.
It's still fun, though.
Well, hopefully it's still fun. I mean, people seem to be still enjoying it. That's the main thing.
Mm-hmm.
So, yeah. So we thought it would be a cool idea to just go through the 4 years, see what has happened, and where we are now, and maybe what's coming up in the future. That's what we always do, basically. So that's not really the biggest thing we can talk about right now. So the first year.
Yeah.
What happened? The game launched on PC, coming out from the PS3 and the Xbox 360 mm-hmm. version with the six base knots and the two extras.
It launched on August 1st, which is 3 months after it launched on PlayStation 3 and Xbox 360. And it launched with eight characters.
Yeah.
So the original gang for PC is Lone Star Froggy G, Voltar Yuri,
Leon,
Coco. Clunk, Coco, and Durple.
Durple, yeah.
There we go.
That's the original eight for PC. It's fun that I always just look at the original six, but I forget that for PC it's the original eight, and it's kind of funny. Yeah.
And shortly after we launched, and the launch went really well, by the way. We did an open beta right before it launched. A lot of people got really excited. And then it launched and it did well, and we launched Gnaw just a couple of weeks after. And then everything went kind of fast. I made a list of the patches and the content that we released during the first year. And in total, we launched Gnaw, Scoldier, Raylan, Vinny and Spike, Genji, and Ayla, which is six knots.
Yeah, in a year. That's crazy.
So compared to the original game, the roster doubled, even more so, in just a year.
Yeah.
And that's, looking back at it, I'm like, wow, how did we manage that?
Yeah, that was crazy. Yeah. That's pretty exciting to see how. I mean, I think that contributed to what made the game, what kept the game going in that story. Because you got to keep people excited for the game, and then getting a lot of new characters keeps it going. And of course, there was a lot of interest from famous YouTubers like Total Biscuit, Jesse Cox, those guys who were talking about the game and who were playing the game. So mm-hmm. that was, and they also contributed to those characters. I mean, look at Genji and Vinny and Spike and also Scoldier, all and even Ayla, all were voiced by pretty famous YouTubers, which was really cool. And it got the game going, and that allowed us to just roll into year two.
Yeah.
Making even more cool stuff for the game.
Yeah, and on top of this, the characters, during the first year, we also released Aguillon.
Oh, yeah, of course.
That was just within a year. But the game also launched without leagues or seasons.
Oh, yeah.
I didn't even know that. I was kind of surprised when I saw this in the list. And the leagues and seasons system was added in a patch to make sure that people don't get stuck in the leaderboards where they are. And the leaks just give them more perspective on what's happening, how well they stack up. And also, skins were added a couple of months after launch.
Yeah, with the first batch being the skins like Grandmaster Splash, Musketeer, Leon, those kinds of guys.
You're naming all the cool ones.
you know which ones I'm talking about. I mean,
Disco Voltar. Let's
Disco Voltar. I mean, back then we were it was the first batch of skins. We didn't really know what we were able to do with them.
Thank you, Kun.
We didn't really know what we were able to do with them. We were still experimenting, and so there were some cool things, and maybe we learned some stuff from what we shouldn't do with skins. Mm-hmm. So, and it made us better skin makers.
It sounds like a horror movie.
Yeah, basically, yeah. So yeah, year one was really exciting, and before we roll into year two and talk about that,
let's talk about something else really
exciting. Because
What
time is it, Robin? I think you're an expert at this time.
It's a rough outside!
Yay! Okay.
Before the show started, Kun was kind of panicking and saying, I'm not ready for this. Kun,
are you ready for this? Should we cue the Space Jam music?
Kun is not nodding yes. Kun, are you ready for this?
Are we going to disappoint the internet? Do we need to stall? We need to stall a little bit.
Well, we're pretty good at doing that.
So, of the original six knots, which one's your favorite? Or should we say eight? From the original eight, what's your favorite? Which one?
That depends. In the way they launched back then, or the way they are now?
Well, can you still remember the difference? What the way they were?
I don't know, I'm just trying to stall.
No, the way they are now, because it's a better reference. You got a better picture of that. I mean, I can't remember for the life of me. I mean, Voldor was way different, but the other changes were so subtle.
Mm-hmm. I'd say Clunk.
Yeah.
I really like Clunk, even especially within the roster we have now. He's so over the top, and so big and strong, and he fires missiles and he bites stuff and he explodes. Everything. Kun is breaking right now. Sorry.
We're breaking somebody.
But Clunk is. Everything about him is really cool.
Well, yeah. Valid argument.
What's your favorite of the original eight?
I like Coco. Because I like to shoot people in the face behind their own turrets. I mean, I'm not really a complicated kind of guy.
Yeah.
In the meantime, we stalled long enough for Kun to get some raffle winners out there. I see the winner for RoboScoop, and I'm going to leave it to you to announce who won the RoboScoop and the game key.
No leaf nutwitch.
What?
Nutwitch? Someone won, yes. He's stalking the chat.
There he is.
Congratulations. You win a RoboScoop and a game key.
And then there's the other winners of the game key are behind the screen.
Damn it, Kun.
Thank you, Kun. Tippes, Bikes,
the 9-0,
the 9-1, the Czech. What the hell are these names? And the Garlic Lord. Congratulations on the game key. Spread the love of Awesomenauts. Or play it yourself if you didn't have it yet, but I find that very hard to believe. So, yeah.
Kun, reset the clock.
Hey, that's a nice timing.
So, our TV just broke.
Yeah, it's a very nice quality of. Better like next time. So, year two. Let's go.
Year two started pretty much with the Kickstarter that we did for Star Story.
That's a nice start of the year.
Yeah, that blew every expectation we had for it.
Yeah, that was crazy. I still remember shooting the Kickstarter video and all the preparation and everything we did for it. And then we were just hoping, I hope we're going to make it. Are we setting the goal too high? Isn't it too much to ask? And then it just exceeded everything we could ever imagine.
I remember looking at the screen a few hours after it launched. And just while I was watching it, in a couple of minutes, like, $5,000 were pledged, and I was like, wow, what have we done?
Yeah, it was really cool, and I mean, we loved all the participation for it from all the community, and the feedback we got, and that all those stretch goals we made. And yeah, it was just an amazing ride, a 30 day insanity.
Roller coaster ride, yeah. Through crazy land.
Yeah, it was, yeah. And then, we ended with a legendary pizza stream.
Yeah.
That was a lot of fun. And so, yeah, that was a great
start. I'm so glad all that footage was lost.
Oh, man.
That was not our finest hour. But if you were there, you probably have some fond memories of it.
Yeah, but so it started with that, and then during the year we started developing those. But before we started developing Starstorm, there was also something else.
During the Kickstarter, we released Admiral Swiggins, which was designed, which was the winner of the first Design a Knot contest.
Yeah,
I can't really remember who made it, but I do. Real good.
Nice.
Wow, that was weird. So Admiral Swiggins was added during the Kickstarter, and is a really cool character because he was designed and picked by the community. That also we also realized that it's kind of difficult to work in a wish list of what people have like that into the game.
Yeah,
because we needed a lot of new systems, a lot of new tech to make both his hook and his anchor drop work.
He was a tricky guy.
But he's awesome, and he's still a really cool character. And after, I still have a list, after Swiggins, we launched Ted in December.
Yeah.
And that might very well be my favorite knot to date.
Oh, seriously?
He's even more awesome than Clunk is.
Oh, wow. My memories of Ted are mainly his development process, and that was pretty, let's say it was interesting and challenging.
We never shy away from a challenge or a bad idea.
Yeah, that was made pretty apparent with Ted. So that was, yeah, that's my main memory of that character. Yeah.
And quite shortly after, we launched Penny, Sentry, and Scree as well.
Yeah, as well. Oh, in the second year still, right? Mm-hmm. Yeah, that was pretty.
Penny was actually the surprise fourth knot.
Yeah, it was the extra character for the with the stretch goals. Yeah.
Penny was voiced by Dodger.
Yeah.
From the game station, if I remember correctly.
I can't remember. Isn't it Polaris now or something?
Yeah. And Scree was voiced by Weasel.
Yeah.
Who's still around, I think. Not sure if he's in the chat, but he's still awesome. And we also added custom games, which I realized, when I was making this list, I realized custom games were one of the stretch goals as well.
Yeah.
And I thought we added that way before, but it actually took us a while.
Yeah.
So, but since then, you can enjoy stuff like Random Knots, and I'm pretty sure Team Deathmatch
Deathmatch and all that kind of stuff, yeah. That's true. Yeah.
But there's still some stretch goals left as well.
Yeah.
So, as we mentioned, we're working on Spectator Mode. Spectator Mode!
Yay!
And we also still have the Level Editor, which is one of the stretch goals that we made, or that we reached well after the original campaign closed.
Yeah, because the pledges were still open and people could still donate money and get the digital rewards. Yeah, it's from the TV, Kun.
Yeah.
I guess they still get the digital rewards.
Yeah.
So yeah. So year two was pretty interesting with mainly comprised the entirety of Starstorm.
Mm-hmm.
So, and then starting year three, we were already way underway with, well underway with Swords and Soldiers 2 development.
Yeah, which developed parallel to
Awesomenauts. And that cut into, and that's where you see the dip in knots being released and that kind of stuff, because the focus was on Swords and Soldiers a lot, but we still released some knots.
Yeah, during that year, we launched Scoop, I think in October that year, Nibs and Rocco.
Yeah.
And Rocco has become one of the most popular characters we have at its time.
Yeah.
And also during that time, we removed the loadout, which
oh,
was
yeah.
a system that had been in place since the game originally launched, which meant that if you weren't around back then, it used to be that if you entered the game, you would actually have to pick which three upgrades
for
every row you wanted to have in the shop. So you kind of need to prepare. You had to prepare your build before going into the game, and then pick your build order in the store itself.
Yeah.
And we changed that to having all the items in the store eliminated to three.
Yeah. So you can adjust yourself more to.
Yeah.
What's going on in the match?
It added a lot more flexibility. And it's also, the original system made a lot more sense back when we still had 6 or 8 characters, because characters were a lot more flexible. Like almost every character could build into being a bit tanky or a bit self-heal and stuff like that.
Yeah.
And as we got more and more characters, it kind of evolved so that characters were less diverse and more focused.
Yeah. We're in this was all year 3, right?
Yeah.
This was in year 3.
Yeah, we also overhauled AI Station 404, which was one of the most problematic maps that we had at the time, just because it had one lane.
Oh, yeah, yeah. And so we basically introduced AI Station 205
yeah.
during that year. Yeah.
Which obviously has 2 lanes and therefore works a lot better. And we introduced Global Chat.
Oh, that was also that year. Oh, interesting. Yeah. That was a nice way for people to find those custom games that we introduced earlier, and for a lot of people to communicate. It's a lot of fun. Yeah.
Yeah, and we've been using custom games a lot more since then.
Yeah.
Because you actually had to find your own friends before.
Yeah,
before.
Now you can just find random people who are also playing the game, which is, that's a lot of, yeah, that's more fun, and you can get more, and you can meet some new people. That's
mm-hmm.
always fun. And with Nibs, the last character of the Starstorm expansion, basically,
mm-hmm.
was finished. So that wrapped up that
Is
part
that
of Starstorm.
Is still your favorite?
It's still my favorite Starstorm character as well. Yeah, my favorite character. Nah, hard to tell. But she's my favorite Starstorm character. Yeah.
Which, did you make all characters that released that year? So Scoop,
In
Nibs,
year
Rocko?
3, yeah. Rocko, Scoop, and Nibs.
And year 2?
I didn't make Scree. Aside from that, yeah, I made all of them.
Wow. So...
yeah. I made a lot of characters, man.
Which was the hardest?
Oh, man. I mean, Rocko was difficult, but it was more of a... It was a bigger problem for people who were not me. Because I didn't make the actual bow thing. I remember Kuhn doing a lot of work on that. So I think Ted was one of the more difficult ones of the entire streak.
All right.
Because of, even just because his gun is in front of his body instead of behind his body.
Is it because of all his muscles?
I wish. I wish it was the muscles, because that would have been fun. So, okay.
Year 4.
You're rolling into year 4.
We launched 4 knots. 5 knots.
5 knots.
Which is pretty good, looking at our score so far.
Yeah, that's pretty good. That's pretty nice. It's a pretty nice average.
So we did Senya, X recently, and all 3 overdrive knots.
Yeah. Year 4 was basically overdrive. A lot of overdrive. And so there were 5 characters, 2 free and 3 paid characters.
Yeah.
So, and X being, of course, the second Design Your Knot contest winner.
Mm-hmm.
And that's pretty cool.
Which, once again, gave us a lot of trouble.
Yeah, it was another challenging character to develop. Yeah.
But it's just like Swiggins, it's a lot of fun. It's one of the... I wouldn't say weirdest, but it's one of the most creative knots that we have.
Yeah.
Just because, like, other people have an entire different way of coming up with ideas for Awesomenauts. And those 2 characters kind of stand out for me.
Yeah, that's true. Yeah. And aside from that, we also launched the Starstorm map, finally.
Which was also a stretch goal.
Was that a stretch goal? I think it
might have been a base goal.
Was it a base? I think it was a base goal. Yeah, it was a base goal for the Kickstarter.
Promise delivered.
Check.
And we also did one of the perhaps most controversial changes to the game since launch. We introduced a leveling patch, which is something that divides a lot of players, even to this day. Even though it's been eight or nine months since it was introduced,
a lot
of people still
quite a while.
Yeah. Personally, I think it made the game a lot better, a more fun, more dynamic.
Yeah.
I know a lot of people agree. I know a bunch of people don't agree. But I do think the game is in a much better place.
Yeah.
Because of it. And looking at what we added over the years, I do really like where it's been going, and I do. It's really impressive to see how far we've expanded on the entire idea and all the content that we've had.
Yeah, and also looking at what's coming up with the Galactron, with the reworks for characters, because Lone Star was also year 4, of course.
Oh, right.
The first rework of a character we did, and was already 4 years old.
Mm-hmm.
And then all the other stuff that's in the pipes that we haven't even discussed, or that are just vague ideas for us, and we still got so much to do for the game. I hope we can make it all come true and make the game even bigger than we've already did over the last 4 years.
Like looking at the stuff that we've got cooking and the stuff that we're discussing internally, there's a lot more coming, and I'm really pretty sure that we're gonna be here in another year, adding a year 5 to the list.
Yeah, definitely.
We should have cake for year 5.
Yeah, I think so. That's a good idea.
So, but yeah, looking forward at year 5, it's obviously going to have the 3.3 patch with Rise of Galactron, which is going to change the entire way players experience the matchmaking system and introduce stuff like the party system, rejoins. The removal of late join, a lot of cool stuff that really changes the way the game works. And it's something I'm really excited about. I know Martinez has been working on it for 2 years, maybe?
Yeah.
Like 1.5 years, something like
that. A really long time.
And we're finally reaching a point where it's ready to go live. And with beta going live later today, it's something you can already check out. It's going to be the future of Awesomenauts, this guy.
That you can't see. Oh yeah, there he is. Yeah. Nice. Nice, Coon. So yeah, that's a somewhat brief recap of the last 4 years. I mean, tell us what is your fondest memory of the last 4 years? And
Yeah, what do you remember? What stands out? Yeah.
Of the last 4 years. So that's
Let's talk about that while I get myself humiliated online.
Yeah. While Robin gets destroyed online.
Yeah, that might be the worst news of today.
Robin's gonna play Awesomenauts. That's your worst news of the day. It can't get any worse than that.
We're pretty good at raising expectations.
Hey.
So we're gonna play live, because there is no beta. Should we play a regular game? I'm League 9.
What time is it?
It's
you can just play a regular game and then you can see what if there's time left for a cool random match. Random death match.
Let's get myself humiliated.
Hey. And then Coon will update us on when it's time.
What are we playing?
I mean, just play Ted, man. You just told everybody. And bam, you pick Ted. You make it festive with the shinies. It's Raffensite! Yay! Now Coon can take his sweet time to pick out some winners, because now we can watch Robin play. Is it a late join?
No, it's not. Like it. Well, I always heard you guys complain that it's really weird to play like this. And it turns out you guys are right.
Oh yeah! No shit, Sherlock!
No swearing, Tim.
Hey man, we're all grown men here.
Grown man kids. More taunting.
More taunting, more fabulous sparkles.
Hey, look at that skin. How do you get that skin, Robin?
What skin? Hey, oh! Man. How nice of you to ask, Tim. I feel like you've explained this to me before, but you get it. As far as I know, you get it by joining the Awesomenauts Steam group.
Yep. And how do you do that?
If you don't have the skin, you should probably have a notification in the...
You That's a lot of dinosaurs.
Me. That's a lot of dinosaurs. Damn it. Why?
So if you follow Awesomenauts on Steam, and you can, the easiest way to do that is go to the Awesomenauts store page and just hit the follow button.
That's right.
Done. You get the free Killer Koala skin.
You mean Augmented Ayla?
Yeah, Killer Koala Ayla, or if she's known, Augmented Ayla. Hey, party pooper. So we've got some winners for the Rafflesite.
Rafflesite.
And the lucky winner of the Robot Scoop skin and a game key is Newcastle M Hull. Those are two football teams from the Premier League. I remember correctly. One of them relegated last year, so that's a bit of a shame. And the winners of the game key are These Knots, Pezanot, Menons, and Cormag. Congratulations on the game key. Give it to a friend. Play the game
or
yourself.
Or enjoy it,
but else give it to a friend. Have your friends play Awesomenauts. Rigged. Sure, man. We really often do get Serona when we play on the stream show.
We also lose a lot.
Yeah, that's true. Although nobody will be surprised if it happens this time. You're shooting the ground, Robin.
I'm shooting the ground. Yeah, I must admit that I thought you guys were worse.
But we sucked at the game.
I thought you guys sucked, but this is
really
harder than I thought it would be.
Yeah. You receive the key through
a private message
on Twitch. So be sure to keep an eye on your inbox. Your Twitch inbox. Your twin box. That doesn't make sense.
This is really horrible.
Dodge the dinosaurs. Nice.
Eat it, Raylan.
Eat it!
You should celebrate my small victories.
Hopefully the beta will go live later today. There were some troubles. There were some issues with the build. So it's going live later today. Later. Is Rafflesite all the time now? I'm not sure. I think Kuhn restarted the clock. So we've got one more Rafflesite. Tetris.
Pew pew.
Come on! Oh, nice! You killed somebody, Robin. The day is saved. The day is not ruined.
Damn it.
The artwork for the Galactron robot will be in the background of the menu during the beta that's coming up. So yeah, you can enjoy it there. We will make a cool desktop background version of it for you.
I want
to enjoy. I think our lead artist already has it as
That's not a good sign.
That's not a good sign in general. No. Who's the host? It's Raylan.
Yeah.
Oh. What's up? Can you chat us? Yeah, nice. Hmm.
who's lead artist. Lead artist is Gijs, or better known as Xin. You can watch him on dev streams on Thursdays, alternating
with
me. I sometimes stream on Thursdays and the other times.
Are you streaming tomorrow?
Yes.
Because Gijs will be here.
Oh, I hear that I'm streaming tomorrow. Go check it out. I will probably be working on Clunk skins. So,
which one are you working on?
The expendable one at the moment. It's, I mean, of course, I did all kinds of stuff during the development of the base version that I have trouble with skins. So yeah. How many artists are there at Ronimo Games?
We're all artists.
Everybody wished they were artists, but we've got 5, 6
Learning counting.
I'm looking at Coon's face. 6, yeah. We've got 6 artists. We've got 6. 2 animators and the rest are just focused on all other kind of stuff. We don't have any interns at the moment because it's summer break. But during the regular season, we've got mainly we also got 2 interns for the art for the artist position. So then we're 8 artists. It's a lot of people, man.
All making knots.
No, they're not. We've got the work distributed evenly among menus and and knots and updates and fixes. Are you ashamed of yourself right now?
I am.
Good. Good. How many programmers? So let's go through all the disciplines. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 7 programmers.
Did you count people or did you count desks?
I counted positions where people sit. We didn't say they were human programmers. Yeah, and we've got 2 designers and 1 producer. What he does all day, I have no clue, but he's there. He's there occupying space, so that's cool. That's cool, man. It's cool. I think without Robin, there wouldn't even be stuff on the stores, and you wouldn't even be able to purchase the game and play it. So yeah, it is nice to be able to have that. Everybody knows programmers are half cyborg. Half of them are cyborgs, and the other half are actual humans. Yeah, that's the paradox, of course. Who writes the code for the programmers? The robots. People in India, we've outsourced that. More robots. We don't outsource our code. I meant the code that writes our programmer robots.
It writes itself. It's Skynet.
It's Skynet, basically. Well, we used to outsource code for the PlayStation 4 and the Xbox One version.
Oh, that's right.
Stay hydrated, man. Hashtag stay hydrated.
Nice.
Nice, oh, you got another kill. Wow, day saved. Hey, the timer's working. Nice. I don't have my glass, so I'm not staying hydrated. I'm failing myself. Robin's hydrated.
He's even got a glass stein.
It's vodka.
Nice. And we don't need to do four necessarily. Depends on the time. When's the art book?
The artwork book.
We're working on it. We've actually had a meeting the other day discussing what we're going to do, how cool we want it to look.
Super cool.
Do we want to make it look super cool, mega cool, or ultra cool? I mean, we can't decide. It's hard to decide, man.
Turbo cool.
Man, we didn't even think of that option.
Back to the drawing board.
So yeah, we're working on that right now. I mean, you gotta keep chatting people, else you won't be eligible for the raffle.
The raffle site?
How are you still alive? Oh, yeah. Nope. Oh, God. Always steal the other people's worms. Yeah, if you should check out the beta. You can just play regular matchmaking, so no need to find custom games filled with people, all that kind of stuff. You can just quick match, and then you will be matched up with people, with folks. Y'all,
folks. We're cool like that.
We're hip and square like that.
We know what the kids like these days.
We know what the kids like these days. Bonkers. They're bonkers.
Awesomenauts go.
Jeepers. Anything that changed in the beta? Well, the beta's had a pretty big update. There's all kinds of balance changes. For everybody that just tuned in, there's all kinds of balance changes in the beta, and there's assists in the beta. And of course, there's a lot of bugs and issues that
have been fixed.
That have been fixed. So, if you had some networking issues last time, they should be fixed now. And of course, there will be beta patch notes, like Kuhn just said in the chat. But especially all the balance changes and the assist system, you should definitely go check that out.
That's not good. I'm disappointing, Kuhn.
How will the ranking system work in 3.3? I mean, I think you were referring to the leaderboards. The leaderboard system is still the old leaderboard system.
Yeah.
It's in place. It's just the behind-the-scenes matchmaking system that's changed in the way you will be matched up.
Yeah, so the matchmaking system will be looking at your actual rank and your rating.
Yeah.
Rather than purely at your league. Now you league with people who are either one league above you in the same league or a league below you. And that's going to change.
Yeah. And with all the changes to things like rejoins and harsher punishments for people who leave and that kind of stuff, people's ratings should be more accurate and it should all work out. The stars will align and then you will have perfect matchmaking.
TMs or
asterisks. We are thinking about new leaderboard systems and stuff, but that's of course lower priority than the actual matchmaking system. So
it's
something
on our to-do list.
It's on
after.
Yeah, it's on the to-do list. So. Oh God, you're gonna die! Run.
It's more here.
Oh, I didn't get the kill though. You would have gotten an assist if this were the beta.
Hey! Wow. But it isn't.
It's not.
Damn it!
Scoop is so tanky, man.
He's also so dead. Damn it. Jinx it. Now I'm gonna die. You're gonna die so bad.
Are you gonna get that worm? It's your biggest nemesis right now. You're blind.
Who made that awesome blind effect?
Who made that? Who made that blind effect?
Kun, do you know? If you don't know, Kun made
the blind effect. Spoiler alert. No, no, you gotta run. The dinosaurs will get you. Everybody. Oh, it's the poison. Nice.
That's not really deserved or anything. It's just, it feels good.
Who made the dinosaurs? I don't know who made the dinosaurs, Robin.
It was me.
Oh, wow. That's a surprise. Kun also made the dinosaurs. And everybody loves the dinosaurs. Our people.
I love them so much I keep eating them.
Somebody saying something about a PS4 patch. That's also very close.
Yeah, we have actually been testing the PS4 version today with all the new content. There were some issues that came up, and we're going to look into fixing those. But it's looking really good.
So yeah, PS4 players, get hype. You've been getting hype for the last long time now, but now there's actual
hype to get.
Hype to get.
Probably a bad position to be in.
Yeah, that it is. Oh god. Oh, run. Gotta push it.
To the limit.
Push it to the limit. Shoot him.
Oh.
Shoot him. Shoot him. Oh no.
That's fine. That's not fine.
Dinosaurs. Oh god.
Do you know any dinosaur puns?
Dinosaur puns?
Those would sure be of use right now.
Dinosaur puns? I don't have any good dinosaur puns. Not very funny. God dang. Oh, nice. Push it, push that. Push that tower to the limit. Shoot it though, not the ground. There we go.
Don't jinx this.
What's up? Look at Rocco.
He's doing pew pew.
Yeah, but he's not moving his arm. That's not intended. Ooh. Live it, I know.
Sorry.
It's very warm in here. I'm getting drowsy.
We want a game on stream. I want a game on
stream. Robin won a game on stream. This is actually a miracle.
It's also a first.
It's also no, it's not a first. Jasper won one 2 weeks ago.
That's right.
For sure.
Wow.
Are there any character changes in the beta? Yes.
There are.
Yeah, there definitely are. There's a lot of balance changes. Robin
yeah.
named some earlier.
Jasper has nerfed Ix and buffed Raylan. And he's also been working on a change to Coco and Lone Star to remove their double slow upgrades. So
and there's an experiment with Vinny and Spike where they do not have any sort of collision with glass platforms.
Yeah, so you can just, if you can drop through it, you'll now just float through it. And I noticed one note I made that we didn't talk about before. In the beta that's going live later today, there is something that we've called auto rematch. If you're in a custom game, and it's done, as games do, you'll return to the lobby screen with the same people in the lobby with the same settings, and if you all just ready up immediately, you'll play the exact same game type as before.
Oh,
so if you like playing custom games with your friends, this should really help speed things up a bit. Because the process of inviting people back and setting up the settings again, even though you can now make presets.
Yeah.
It just makes it a lot easier.
It can get a bit tedious, so now you can easily do that. Yeah. I think we've only got a few more minutes left in the stream.
Alright, we should do
There's a raffle in about 2 minutes.
Oh. Shall we do a Randomnauts team deathmatch?
Do we have time for that?
I don't know what time it is.
It's we got 3 minutes.
Let's set it. Let's do it. Oh. Set it to 15 kills.
Yeah, that's fast.
16 kills.
16 kills. That will also be easier with the new settings. Maybe. Hey. Oh, there you go. Just type it though. Just ask it. Try. Go, 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 go.
I'll drink some more vodka.
Nice. One more slot, people.
Hello, Trigger. Hello, Lucky. An auto refresher in Jambo.
Jambo.
Jambo. LFT. Jambo. Jambo.
Rolls right off the tongue. Jambo. One more. One more. One more.
Do it.
Do it. Do it now. Faster. Oh,
slightly disappointing. Yeah. If you want to join us for a random team deathmatch,
for some reason one slot seems to be cursed and not filling up. It's gonna be great. Live television on the internet. You will be in it.
Next, it says raffle tight.
As is raffle tight.
Raffle tight.
Yeah. There we go. Yeah. So you start the game. Everything's random, yeah, even the map's random. Noise. Okay, yeah, we've got some Raffenzeit.
Raffenzeit. Ready up.
What's that line saying after? Noise. The winner of today's, the last RoboScoop of the day is...
Shizmay. And that rhymes.
And apparently, according to my most reliable information, that's actually a member of Harry Butchers and the Boys. Is that true?
That is true.
That's fun. So you get an extra prize.
You're a double winner.
You're a double winner, man. Then we've got the winners of the thingy, the game,
the
game. We've got the winners of the game key, which are M. Luzak, Yolonauts, Alankalum, nice. And why not 0729? Why not?
Sounds good to me.
That sounds familiar to me as well. Maybe
Alan KLM won before.
Yeah. Okay. So there are some earlier winners. Be sure to give the game away to a friend, family, your dog,
distant relation,
your neighbor, your grandma. Give some keys away in the retirement home. Get those people playing Awesomenauts.
Sounds good.
Sounds good. Sounds diddly. You
you're actually in the lead.
This is three on two.
Okay, so if you're...
Hey, Bringing Sexy back has joined us. Thank you.
He's actually bringing Sexy back to this match. I mean, I was about to say, although this might not be entirely fair then, that if you actually manage to win a team deathmatch live on stream, that's a first.
Mm-hmm.
And it seems to be happening.
Thanks for jinxing this.
Although I think it's Jambo and Trigger. Yeah, they're okay. Here's the comeback. Winds of change. The winds of Ayla, more like. Lol. Oh, Ayla, where are you going?
I live.
Yeah. Dude, still. Oh God. This is exciting. I don't know what you're doing, but it's working.
I think no one knows what I'm doing.
A refresher got a kill. That was greedy. Penny got greedy. Them jukes. Sexy back?
No!
But you're still not dead, man. That's a bloody miracle. You're actually getting kills as well. One more kill.
Is it gonna happen?
It's gonna happen.
Am I gonna live through?
Wow.
I live.
This is a miracle. This is a miracle. Wow, Robin. I didn't know it was possible, but you did it. You did it. You actually won a team deathmatch game on stream.
Yeah. I don't know what to say.
I think there isn't a better time to end the stream than with a victory.
That's true.
Deathmatch victory.
Yeah.
Wow, that's crazy.
Damn. Thanks to my
teammates. I'm reeling here, man. I don't know what to say.
Yeah. Yeah, the script doesn't cover this.
The script does not cover this. Okay. So, I guess that was it for today. Quit while you're ahead. Thank you guys so much for watching. Be sure to check out the beta later today. The details for it will be on the forum, the patch notes, all the changes and that kind of stuff. When it will be live, it will most likely be announced on Twitter.
Yeah, later today. Before we went into the show, they told us later today.
Keep your fingers crossed, else it will probably be later this week. We will keep you updated.
Yeah.
So thanks again for watching. We'll be back next week with
more losses.
More losses. what you actually expect from us? More surprises and good times all around. Goofs and gas.
Thanks, Tim.
thanks for winning, Robin.
You're really welcome.
Cool. So see you guys again next week and
bye.
Goodbye. See you later. Bye bye.